Hi everyone and welcome to this video. So in this exercise we're given some information about a whole life insurance. And the idea is to calculate the net premium policy value 10 years from now. So let's have a look at that. Well, to begin with these type of questions, it's always good to start by calculating, well, what is this single premium? Or in this case, we have level annual premium for 20 years. What is the level of this annual premium? So we start with calculating the present value of all the cash flow streams. So, well, our payment should equal the benefits that we receive. So what do we pay? Well, this premium P, and we pay it annually for 12 years. In other words, we have this annuity due for 20 years where we pay the premium immediately at the beginning of the year. Well, what are the benefits? Well, we receive 100,000 let's say we well in the question it says well we receive 50,000 in the first 2 years and 100,000 thereafter, but let's say we would receive 100,000 for our entire lifetime, or in case in the event of death, then well, we would multiply it with this whole life insurance. But obviously, as I already said, in the first 20 years, we only receive this only 50,000. So we actually need to subtract that part that we've counted too much so far. In other words, we subtract a term insurance of 20 years from this 100,000. So in the end, this exactly equals the benefit stream that we receive. Well, then if we want to calculate these level annual premiums, what we do is, well, we divide the benefits by the payments, and what we now want to realize is that, well, these term insurances, that we can rewrite them in terms of and pure endowment factors and whole life insurances, because those are typically given in these life tables. Well, then how do we calculate this 20-year term insurance? Well, what we first do is, well, it's obviously the 40-year whole life insurance minus the pure endowment part term times the whole life insurance term. So basically we say, well, let's say we have a whole life insurance starting from age 40, then after 20 years, we don't need to receive any payments anymore. So that's why we subtract that. Similarly, what we can do for the annuity due is that we say, well, it's the whole life annuity due minus the pure endowment factor times the annuity due that starts 20 years from now. So then again, we subtract all the payments that occur after 20 years. And from this standard ultimate survival model with an interest rate of 5% per year, which you can find in the back of the textbook, we see that, well, this term insurance part equals $0.01463. The annuity due part equals 12.99 348. And what we also have is that the whole life insurance term part, because we also need that over here, equals 0.12106. So I just looked up all the individual values and only gave you the end result. So then what we see is, well, this single premium then equals 875.38 roughly. Well, and then the idea is, because that's what we were asked, is, well, what is this net premium policy value? Well, given that we know this premium, we can calculate this policy value, because let's say if we take a prospective view, so we look at all the payments that still need to occur in the future, what we can then see is, well, this net premium policy value, or the reserve, so to say, at time t, equals, well, the benefits that we still need to receive. So 100,000 times a whole life insurance starting at age 50 instead of 40 now. So here we first had 40, now we have 50 because we're looking 10 years from now. And then obviously also minus the 50,000 for the remaining time. Well, and what's also an outgoing cash flow is, well, the premium that we're paying, right? But now noting that we only pay 10 more premiums. Well, if we now again note that from this standard ultimate survival model with an interest rate of 5%, what we find is, well, this whole life insurance starting at age 50 is 0.18931. The term insurance part for 10 years equals, if I again write it in the expression as before, .01461. And finally, also, if we look at the annuity part, then we can also write it in a similar form, which equals 8.05500. And then if we use all these numbers to calculate the reserve, what we then find is that this net premium policy value 10 periods from now equals 11,149.02. So in the end, when once we know the premium P, and you know how to write the expression for this net premium policy value, it's easily calculated.